One of the goals of this cruise is to dive in the area which is relatively unknown, the Sur de Biscaya Rise, which is one of the major structures that can tell us a little bit about the history of the initial stages of the seafloor spreading of the Atlantic Ocean. One of the major goals of this cruise was to characterize and to describe some of the major species that we'll find in this area. The first dive was really amazing, more than 11 hours of footages from the deep sea. We collect the samples that we expected to collect, and we have now in front of us a lot of work in order to see all the footages, all the photos, images, and to make some work in order to better understand this benthic ecosystem and also the kind of habitat, the geological ground of this particular area.
The ROV goes into the water, and then when we reach the bottom, we start annotating all the diversity that we can find down there, and try to identify the species, take some photographs, sampling all the substrate and the specimens as well. There were a lot of volaturians, a lot of biology that is characteristic of a sediment place. Then we start climbing a slope, and the landscape has changed and the biodiversity has changed as well. We start finding different corals.
We had to do a long wipe to get to the to start to find outcrops and to find rocks. That's the one that are most interesting to me to study and to finally collect them. This is a very unknown location. From the structure that we have observed, from the bathymetry data that we have collected here, and then from the observations from the ROV, it's definitely a volcanic location. And now, in the future, we will have to look at the samples to see what kind of volcanism and what they can tell us about the story of this place.
When we get the samples on board, then we process the samples and we try to identify all the organisms and then storage them, take some photographs, and that's it. The biology is important because we can try to map all the biodiversity on the deep sea, and that's important to because we are a government institution and we are complied to report all the data that we do find in the ocean. So it comprehends all the species that we find, and we can exactly discover what is down there, and that's important for mapping all the ocean.
Yes, and of course during the cruise and during all the transits we are doing some multi-beam mapping. This is also crucial because we still know very, very little from the morphology in high resolution of the deep sea. So we also take advantage of having these kind of vessels with the multi-beam sonars, and we are always acquiring this multi-beam that will contribute to better achieve the goals of the seabed mapping. Going to the deep sea, and particularly with this kind of equipment as the ROV Luzu, every time that you land at a particular site, you feel that it's something like landing in the moon. In fact, we know so little from the deep ocean, and we have so few direct images and footages from this particular area that covers most of the surface of our planet, that I feel always like a kind of astronaut.
Every time you do an ROV dive, because you get to see the seafloor, it's magical. It's always a surprise, it's something new. It's a place that probably no one has been yet. So it's very mysterious, and it's full of things to discover and geological process to watch and place to characterize. So it's magical to be on board.
Well, the deep sea is absolutely extraordinary. I love the deep sea. I love the feeling of discovering something new that was never found before, and we are the first persons to look at those images for the first time. So that's a wonderful sense of exploration. So I love the deep sea.
I think it was a very nice leg, the first leg of this cruise. We had a multidisciplinary team on board, and the environment was quite nice. There was really a great friendship amongst all. In the end, I think that everyone was really happy to contribute for the successful of this leg, and I really acknowledge them for that.